Striving to to build a brighter dawn for our children to call their own. Cordillera, region of wonder, hail, beloved land, your name we shall not fail. Honor and fame to you we'll strive to bring.
Good morning to all. Thank you to each and every one of you for being here with us today. We are very pleased to be able to welcome those of you who have been with us in our earlier conferences, as well as those who are joining us for the first time. This third International Conference on Cordillera Studies was supposed to be held in July last year, but it had to be postponed because of the pandemic. I would like to thank the paper presenters and speakers for your patience and sustained interest. Several months into the new normal, platforms for a virtual conduct of webinars and conferences have emerged. Models for such virtual events have demonstrated that objectives of international conferences can be achieved, albeit through remote communication. This virtual mode for ICCS3 enables a wide international and local participation despite mobility restrictions at this time. The capacity of the virtual platform to record the conference proceedings also allows the archiving of materials which can be curated and made accessible for us in remote teaching and learning, as well as research and policy discussions, because it's also possible to broadcast the conference through public platforms such as Facebook and YouTube. The University of the Philippines, Baguio, is able to include and encourage the engagement of members of the public who would otherwise not be able to join in the traditional face-to-face conduct of this conference. It is therefore a mixed blessing that this conference can be done in this virtual platform, and we are confident that the proceedings will benefit international researchers, faculty members of UP and other state universities, students, policymakers, and the general public. In today's gathering, in the subsequent Mondays of July, we come together to share, learn, and ponder on the ideas that will inform our understanding of sustainable development and our role in the achievement of this great aspiration. We will listen to studies, initiatives, projects, and various actions that are being done by individuals, organizations, and agencies that contribute towards the realization of the Sustainable Development Goals, especially among marginalized sectors like indigenous peoples. A very warm welcome to all. We wish we could have you hosted you all here at UP Baguio. I am sure, however, that the gathering in our virtual venue will be lively, hopeful, and inspiring, as the two earlier conferences have been. Thank you and enjoy our conference.
Greetings to everyone, to all of you from around the world. Welcome to the third International Conference on Cordillera Studies. Congratulations and thanks to the Cordillera Studies Center of the University of the Philippines in Baguio for organizing this event. Just a bit of a backgrounder. In 2015, the UN General Assembly adopted a resolution on the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. At the core of this resolution are the 17 Sustainable Development Goals, or SDGs as we know them, which were an outgrowth of the 8 Millennium Development Goals, or MDGs, to reduce extreme poverty by 2015. The 17 new SDGs raise the stakes, so to speak, for the next 15 years. The 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development aims to free the human race from the tyranny of poverty and want, and to heal and secure our planet, and to take bold and transformative steps to shift the world on to a sustainable and resilient path. The agenda makes a lofty pledge that no one will be left behind. For the world's roughly 370 million indigenous peoples, this pledge carries a hefty weight. Indigenous peoples have been left behind in every social, economic, and political indicator. This is the effect of widespread discrimination, geographical and political exclusion, limited infrastructure and capital investment, and of course, decades and centuries of oppression. Indigenous peoples make up approximately 5% of the world's population, but they comprise 15% of those living in extreme poverty. A 2016 World Bank study of poverty trends in 10 countries in Latin America, Asia, and Africa revealed that in each of these countries, indigenous peoples are not only poorer, but their poverty is more severe than the non-indigenous population. Moreover, their poverty rates fall more slowly than national average rates, indicating that their chances of overcoming such poverty are extremely difficult. Aware of the gaps in the MDGs that had rendered them nearly invisible, indigenous peoples actively participated in the global consultation process that crafted the 2030 agenda. During the 2016 High-Level Political Forum, the Indigenous Peoples Major Group submitted a paper expounding on the theme of ensuring that no one is left behind. This paper, incidentally, was co-developed by the Baguio City-based Thedd Foundation, which counts among its board of trustees UP Baguio Anthropology Professor Jessica Carino and UP Baguio History Professor and former Chancellor Raimundo Rovilios. This paper emphasized that indigenous peoples must not be treated as mere recipients of development, but as active agents and drivers of change who contribute directly to sustainable development. Indigenous peoples nurture the planet's most biologically diverse areas, managing 80% of the Earth's biodiversity while occupying only 22% of the planet's surface. Their traditional knowledge systems, innovations, and practices present a wealth of resources for new healthcare systems, ecosystem management and conservation, and agricultural production and food security. Indigenous peoples are vital partners in the implementation of the SDGs. This is reflected in the 2030 Agenda, which calls for the empowerment of indigenous peoples and their engagement in the implementation of the agenda. In fact, indigenous peoples are referenced explicitly in the SDGs 6 times, such as in SDG 2, Target 3, on doubling the agricultural productivity and incomes of small-scale food producers, in particular, indigenous peoples. And in SDG 4, Target 5, on ensuring equal access to all levels of education and vocational training for indigenous peoples. Many of the SDGs are relevant to the well-being of indigenous peoples. 73 out of the 169 SDG targets are linked to provisions of the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. They are also linked to the ILO Convention No. 169 or the Indigenous and Tribal Peoples Convention of 1989. As we all know, the COVID-19 pandemic has caused widespread human suffering everywhere. It has exposed every inequality that there is, from the lack of basic amenities and healthcare to the lack of information, often delivered in languages and through mediums that are inaccessible to indigenous peoples. However, as the UN itself has said, the pandemic serves as an unprecedented wake-up call, laying bare the failures in our current political, economic, and social systems. The pandemic has made it impossible for us to turn away from the truth that our lives are all interconnected and that when we leave behind even one, we all pay the price. Now is our chance to recreate our world, to find out where we are and to reach out to those who could not cope with the run. As UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres said, we need to turn the recovery into a real opportunity to do things right for the future. To do this, we can turn to our higher education institutions, which serve as venues where divergent voices can tell their stories, be heard, and be attended to. Conferences such as this one are valuable platforms for enlightened discussions, the presentation of data and research results, and most importantly, the sharing of experiences, struggles, and lessons learned. Through this conference, in particular, we can engage in dialogues with our government partners, in civil society, in international agencies, and in the communities, thereby drawing a more accurate map of where the indigenous peoples are concerning the 17 SDGs. And so I am glad and proud to see UP Baguio, led by Chancellor Corazon Abansi, organizing this third international conference on Cordillera Studies. Although through an online venue that has opened up this event to a broader global audience, UP Baguio leads Indigenous Studies in Northern Philippines through its Cordillera Studies Center. It is headed by its director, Dr. Ruth Tindaan. The CSE has produced renowned academics and researchers, such as UP Baguio Professor Emeritus of Anthropology, June Pril Brett, and UP Baguio Associate Professor of Anthropology, Dr. Annalyn Salvador Amores. Dr. Amores is a University of Oxford alumna, NAST Outstanding Young Scientist, and Metrobank Outstanding Teacher Awardee. Moreover, in September this year, UP Baguio's PhD in Indigenous Studies program will roll out. It is the only program of its kind across the entire UP system. In fact, this program is the first of its kind in Southeast Asia. It is undoubtedly a big step towards inclusiveness in support of sustainable development of our indigenous peoples, particularly in the Cordillera region. I sincerely hope that we can work together to envision a new world rising from the ashes of the pandemic during this four-day conference, a world that deeply respects all human life and our very own planet, a world that provides enough to enable all to live a safe, decent, and fulfilled life, a world that allows all peoples and cultures the social, cultural, and political space to nurture themselves, their needs and grievances, and their aspirations for unique beauty and wisdom. Thank you very much, and I wish you all a productive and engaging time. Thank you, and keep safe.
The National Commission on Indigenous Peoples, the duly mandated government office to protect the interests of indigenous peoples in the country, fully support the University of the Philippines activities through the Cordillera Studies Center, Thedd International Virtual Conference on Cordillera Studies with the theme Indigenous Peoples and Sustainable Development Goals. UP's effort for international and continuing engagement for governance and development bodies. Your partner, the National Commission on Indigenous Peoples, is very supportive of this activity, considering that it fully supports the four bundles of rights to it. Number one, ancestral domain and ancestral lands. We know that your office or the university is very supportive on this. Dapat respetuhin ang territory occupied by the indigenous peoples. Number two, social governance and empowerment. We know that the University of the Philippines is very supportive to the requests of the indigenous peoples for the recognition of our self-governance and self-determination. This is clearly provided for in Section 13 of the Indigenous Peoples' Rights Act. Likewise, Section 14 of the IPRA clearly provides the support to autonomous region. We know that the University of the Philippines is very supportive for the establishment of autonomous region in the Cordillera. Number three, social justice and human rights. We know that your program through the Cordillera Studies Center is very supportive of our equal protection and non-discrimination of the indigenous cultural communities and indigenous peoples. Lastly, cultural integrity. We are promoting unity in diversity. Here in the Cordillera, gusto po natin ipaglaban ang establishment of the Cordillera Autonomous Region para tayo po ay pantay-pantay sa harap o mata ng batas. Likewise, our fight for sustainable development. Sana po ang kayamanan ng Cordillera ay suportahan ng gobyerno. Ang karapat-dapat na maibigay sa mga katutubo ay dapat ibigay ng gobyerno at ibigay ng mga investors sa ating mga katutubo dito sa Cordillera. Again, ladies and gentlemen, we fully support your program through the Cordillera Studies Center for this international virtual conference. Salamat po at mabuhay po tayong lahat.
Kapitan, sinakpat to'y kampi.
kampilan. O ospiyan Diyos, O ospiyan Diyos. Bangon, bangon ka, Ina.
Kinakailangan tayo ang henerasyon na magwawakas sa matinding kahirapan.
Tayo.
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 Ang henerasyon
na pinakapursigidong
labanan
ang kawalan ng hustisya
at hindi pagkakapantay-pantay.
At ang henerasyon
na siyaring susumpo sa climate change.
At ito ang gagawin natin.
Ang Sustainable Development Goals,
15 taong plano para sa ating lahat
sa bawat sulok ng mundo,
wala tayong iiwanan.
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundong walang sinuman ang dumaranas
ng matinding kahirapan.
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundo kung saan
walang nagugutom at gumigising sa umagang nagtatanong,
may kakainin ba ngayon?
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundo kung saan walang taong namamatay
sa sakit na may lunas.
At kung saan
ang tamang pangangalaga
ng kalusugan ay panghabang buhay.
Ang karapatan ng lahat.
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundo kung saan lahat ay nakakapag-aral
at nabibigyan ng sapat na kaalaman
at kasanayan
para sa isang masaganang buhay.
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundo kung saan lahat ng kababaihan
at lahat ng batang babae
ay may patas na oportunidad
upang umunlad,
maging matibay at ligtas.
Hindi tayo magtatagumpay
kung kalahati ng mundo
ay naiiwanan.
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundo kung saan
lahat ay mayroong malinis na tubig
at maayos na palikuran.
Sa bahay,
sa paaralan,
at sa trabaho.
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundong
may sapat na enerhiya
para sa lahat.
Init, ilaw at
kuryente na hindi sumisira sa mundo.
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundong umuunlad
ang mga ekonomiya
at ang kayamanang tinatamasa
ay siya rin magbibigay
ng disenteng trabaho para sa lahat.
Mamumuhay tayo
sa isang mundo kung saan ang ating
mga industriya,
infrastruktura,
at pinakamahusay na inobasyon
ay bilang ginagamit upang magpayaman.
Hindi pa makayaman ang buhay natin lahat.
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundong walang diskriminasyon at labis na di pagkakapantay-pantay
sa loob ng ating bansa
sa pagitan ng mga bansa.
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundo kung saan
ang lungsod at komunidad ay ligtas,
maunlad at sumusuporta sa mga naninirahan dito.
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundo kung saan ibinabalik natin
ang ating kinuha
sa inang kaligtasan.
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundong desididong sukuin
ang banta ng climate change.
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundo
kung saan pinangangalagaan natin ang ating mga karagatan.
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundo kung saan pinangangalagaan natin ang buhay sa kalupaan,
mga kalupaan, mga hayop
at ang kabuuan ng ating dibdib.
Mamumuhay tayo sa isang mundo kung saan may kapayapaan sa bansa,
kung saan ang lahat ng pamahalaan ay may pananagutan,
at isang mundo
kung saan mamamayani ang hustisya at bawat isa ay pantay sa harap ng batas.
At tayo ay dapat mamuhay sa isang mundo kung saan ang lahat ng bansa
at ang kanilang mga mamamayan
ay magtutulungan upang isakatuparan ang Sustainable Development Goals
sa lahat ng mga tao at sa lahat ng sulok ng mundo.
Ito
ang United Nations Sustainable Development Goals.
Tayo na't kumilos.
Sabay-sabay natin isakatuparan ito.
Para sa atin.
Upang wala may iiwan.
Ito ang United Nations Sustainable Development Goals.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place could be much brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. In this place, you'll feel there's no hurt or sorrow. There are ways to get If you care enough for the living, make a little space, make a better place. Heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me. Know why there's a love that cannot lie. Love is strong, it only cares for joyful giving. If we try, we shall see. In this bliss we cannot feel fear or dread. We stop existing and start living. Then it feels that always love's enough for us growing. Make a better world. For the living, make a better place for you and for me. And the dream we were conceived in, we're living a joyful face. And the world we once believed in will shine again in grace. Then why do we keep strangling life on this earth crucified soul? Though it's plain to see this world is heavenly, be God's glory. For the living, make a better place for you and for me. Heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you. Make a better place. Heal the world we live in. Save it for our children. Heal the world we live in. Save it for our children. Make a better place. Make a better place. Make a better place. Make a better place.
With the adoption of the Sustainable Development Goals by United Nations member states in 2015, these global goals now inform national and international plans of action for achieving equitable prosperity and well-being in and among nations. To achieve the SDGs, the UN promotes a multi-stakeholder approach which recognizes the role of every sector in the interconnected tasks that must be undertaken. Among the stakeholders, the academe is identified to hold a significant role, not only in disseminating knowledge about the SDGs through its institutions, but also in mobilizing knowledge communities or networks of expertise and practice to find solutions for specific development challenges. The influence of the SDG framework in the overall direction and management of academic institutions is indicated by how it is now being used not only as a roadmap for action, but also an indicator of performance. To gauge how academic institutions are responding to their role as a significant sector in the attainment of the SDGs, university ranking platforms such as the Times Higher Education University Impact Rankings incorporate the SDGs into their criteria. Universities are now being assessed on how well they advance the cause of sustainable development. By organizing this conference, which features the SDGs as a central theme, the Cordillera Studies Center of UP Baguio performs its role as a research center, mobilizing knowledge communities to seek solutions for sustainable development concerns. In doing so, the CSC increases the social impact of the University of the Philippines in terms of helping the country achieve the SDGs. And consequently, it earns further qualifications for UP for social impact, not only in the rankings, but also in real social consequence. In addition to the substantial and instrumental goals which this project can achieve for the university, it also responds to the call for quality assurance. As the third installment of an international conference organized by the CSC, this project is both a result of assessment of the earlier initiatives and an attempt to advance what had been achieved. The first international conference on Cordillera Studies, held on February 2008, addressed the general theme Indigenous Peoples and Local Communities in Transition. This conference covered significant transformations in the Cordillera, where contemporary forces of change, such as globalization, electronic technology, and migration, were profoundly altering the lives of indigenous peoples. On the other hand, the second ICCS, which was held on July 2017, had a general theme, Indigenous Studies in the Philippines, Issues and Prospects. The conference allowed participants to discuss and identify directions on how Indigenous Studies, as a distinct field of inquiry, can be established and consolidated in the Philippines. It can be noted that the two earlier conferences were successful in accounting for the expanse of knowledge production on the Cordillera and in facilitating the scholarly discussion of recent developments, perspectives, approaches, and debates in the study of the Cordillera region and other indigenous communities. Building on the network of enthusiasm generated by the earlier conferences, the third ICCS takes a step further by directing the discourse on Cordillera Studies to move more toward social engagement in addition to knowledge production and scholarly exchange. The earlier conferences have disseminated a prolific body of work on Cordillera Studies and have explored avenues for pursuing Cordillera Studies as an academic enterprise. Having such foundation, the ICCS3 fuses to focus energies on one central urgent social concern, that of achieving sustainable development among indigenous communities, especially in the context of current health crisis and other challenges such as food security, environmental protection, natural resource management, and overall well-being of these communities. With Indigenous Studies and Concerns on Indigenous People's Welfare as the niche of UP Baguio, this conference takes on a purposeful outlook in producing concrete ideas and workable solutions which can be utilized into effective governance and social mobilization by attentive officials and citizens. I would like to echo the aim of the SDGs, leave no one behind. This is a challenge not just for UP Baguio, but for all of us who are attending this conference. As we participate in the sessions in all Mondays of July, let us keep in mind that we are doing this not just for ourselves, but for others as well, especially those who are left behind. We strive to achieve sustainable development for all, including indigenous peoples. As a university mandated to serve the Filipino people, UP encourages you to collaborate with us in achieving the SDGs and in fostering inclusive development through fruitful conversations and exchanges of innovative ideas, such as what we intend to do in this conference. With confidence in what we can achieve together, and in this conference and in the forthcoming collaboration activities that will and should be done afterwards, I now declare the virtual third International Conference on Cordillera Studies officially open.
From a farming community in northern Luzon, Annalyn and Tony moved to the city some time ago to find a better life for their family. Years later, they still dream of a decent job for themselves, a home they can afford, a healthy family, and being able to keep their three children in school.
People say that the Philippines is getting richer, and I do see more cars on the road, huge houses behind high fences, and large shopping malls. But this is a kind of life that we can only dream of.
Annalyn's family is among the over 3 million poor households in the Philippines that have not benefited from the country's economic growth. Less than 1% of the population owns much of the country's wealth. Many are left behind. In 2015, the Philippines joined the member states of the United Nations in adopting Agenda 2030, including the 17 Sustainable Development Goals, or SDGs, a 15-year plan to end poverty and hunger, ensure education and decent work for all, bring about income and gender equality, provide universal health coverage, protect the environment, and achieve lasting peace. The 17 SDGs work together to ensure that the fruits of development are enjoyed by all and that no one is left behind. Since 2015, the government and the UN have been continuously working together to harmonize plans and be responsive to the needs of the people. Our collective goal is to end poverty and help achieve peace and prosperity for all. Due to time and resource constraints in meeting all the 17 goals by 2030, the government and the UN in the Philippines have agreed to focus on the goals that present the greatest challenges, but which also have the potential for the most impact. While poverty was significantly reduced in 2018, there are still more than 17.6 million Filipinos living on less than $40 a month. We need to help lift more people out of poverty at a much faster rate. Half of the country's 108 million population in 2019 are below 25 years of age. Further economic growth of the country depends on whether these young people become healthier and more educated. However, the Philippines has one of the highest numbers of stunted children in the world. One in three children are short for their age. Teenage pregnancy is among the highest in the region. The number of women who die from pregnancy-related causes is too high, a trend that is caused by poor nutrition and lack of access to quality services. Decent jobs are hard to come by. The low-paying jobs available to the poor do not pay enough to live on, to provide food and education. Rapid urbanization and economic growth on top of climate change is not sustainable and is causing serious damage to the environment. Lastly, peace remains fragile, especially in conflict-affected areas such as the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao. There can be no development without peace. The Philippines and the United Nations have agreed to work together to respond to these development challenges. The Partnership Framework for Sustainable Development, which was signed in November 2018, commits the Philippines and the United Nations to ensure a prosperous future for everyone in the country. The UN will use its global competence and experience working with the government to serve the people, to ensure that everyone in our society is healthy, food secure, and well-nourished. The vulnerable and underserved will be given particular attention, including women, children, people with disabilities, indigenous people, and those living in geographically isolated and disadvantaged areas. The partnership seeks to ensure that decent jobs are made available and pay fairly to provide for the needs of families. Urbanization and economic growth must be supported by environmental protection. The partnership will strengthen the Philippines' ability to respond to climate change, especially in the context of frequent natural disasters. Recent calamities and environmental challenges have shown that urbanization and economic growth cannot be achieved and sustained at the expense of the environment. Climate action, building resilience, and protecting the environment are essential to sustainable and inclusive economic growth to counter the worst effects of climate change. Just as importantly, the partnership framework emphasizes that sustainable and inclusive economic growth is impossible without just and lasting peace. Under the partnership framework, the Philippines and the United Nations will catalyze peace and respect for diversity through dialogue and conflict resolution in communities. By creating decent jobs and resilient livelihoods, poverty and underdevelopment, the root causes of most conflicts, will be addressed. People will also be empowered to lead and participate in governance processes. By 2023, the Philippines and the UN expect to pave the way for Annalyn, her family, and millions of others seeking a better life and livelihood. This will help accelerate their journey. This will also put the Philippines on a steady footing as it strides towards 2030, the finish line for achieving the Sustainable Development Goals and Agenda 2030.
The road that lies ahead of us is long. I do not know what awaits, but I am certain that my family and I, and everyone like us, are not alone in aspiring and working for the future we want, the future we need.
The Partnership Framework for Sustainable Development, the roadmap to development that leaves no one behind.